Okay. Put the heading. Section number 128. What is that? Books of accounts. Now, your choice. I'll make a huge chart in which total books of accounts section will come. Or one by one, divide it into parts and you can do. That is your call. What do you want? Ek hi paper pe chart bana do. So take a landscape paper then. Fresh page. Landscape paper le lo. Theek hai? Now take a landscape paper and divide it into four parts. Divide it into four parts like this. First part mein we'll do meaning of books of accounts, features of books of accounts, and where do we keep it. ठीक है, these are the things we'll cover under the first head of our chart. Then in the second chart we'll understand books of accounts in electronic form. ठीक है, so we'll understand this part in the second column. In the third column we'll understand inspection and preservation of books of accounts. ठीक है, and last में we'll understand key responsible persons. And key responsible persons and penalty on non-compliance. Little bit lengthier but very easy. Will take 15-20 minutes to understand this particular section. Now let us understand this section. Okay? What is the point number one? Meaning of books of accounts, features, and where do we keep it? Ab sunna dhyan se. Whenever the word called books of accounts should come to your mind, section 128 kya bolta hai? Ki three things should come to your mind. Assets, liabilities, sales, purchase, receipts and payments. What are the three things? Receipts and payments ko you can call it as income and expenditures also. So what are the three things? Statement of assets and liabilities, statement of sales and purchase, and statement of incomes and expenditures, which is also known as receipts and payment. Additionally, fourth thing is called cost records, if any. What is the word used? Cost records, if any. What do you mean by cost records, if any? It is not applicable to every company. Nah? That's why they use in the bracket, if any. It means to the applicable companies, then it will be four set of books of accounts. Assets, liabilities, sale, purchase, receipts and payment, and cost records. So, right, means statement of assets and liabilities, sales and purchases, receipts and payments, cost records, if any. यहाँ पे CRA1 लिख लो. The more and more you will repeat the things, na, it will go embedded in your head. CRA1. This is called the meaning of books of accounts. Point number one. Now, what are the features of the books of accounts? Books of accounts कैसी होनी चाहिए? Books of accounts are on based on single entry system or double entry system? Double entry system. So based on double entry system. Second thing, they are what in nature? Summarized in nature or explanatory in nature? What is prepared from what, by the way? Financial statements are prepared from what? Books of accounts, which are on the balance sheet date. So which one is summarized? Financial statements are summarized. It means books of accounts must be explanatory in nature. explanatory. इन नेचर तो कीवर्ड्स बस याद करते जाओ, इसको अंडरलाइन कर लो एक्सप्लेनेटरी को. नेक्स्ट वन, दे शुड बी ऑन विच बेसिस, कैश बेसिस और अक्रूअल बेसिस. कंपनीज एक्ट डज नॉट अलाउ कैश बेसिस. एनजीओ होते ना एनजीओस, दे हैव एन ऑप्शन टू मे इधर गो फॉर कैश और अक्रूअल, तो मस्ट बी ऑन अक्रूअल बेसिस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग. And most importantly, must represent which view? Untrue and fair, and true and fair. True and fair. Must represent true and fair view. Yoga apna meaning or yoga apna features. ठीक है? Breaking it into small small parts so that you can understand this. Put together, it will be 128. 7-8 topics will do and it will understand that 128 is already gone. Okay, next, where do we keep it? Or maintain it? Where do we keep it and where do we maintain it? Tell me one thing, where do you generally find the books of accounts? In your house or registered office? So generally at registered office. Okay? Now, if you are having two types of branches, dependent branches, independent branches. So dependent branches will be, their books of accounts will be maintained by head office. So their books of accounts will also be kept at head office. But if you have independent branches, they'll be maintaining and keeping it at their branch office only. So, right, in case of dependent branches, put the arrow and write kept at head office. Kept and maintained by head office, right? Simple, easy to learn. Next point. What if your books of accounts are maintained in the registered office and that registered office is outside India? That is for inspection. If your books of accounts are outside India and your registered office is also outside India, then quarterly basis it shall be sent to the Indian office. Did you get the point? So, right, if books of accounts are maintained and kept outside India, then what is the answer? On quarterly basis. ये word याद कर लेना, quarterly. MCQ के लिए अच्छा है. Semi-annually पूछ सकते हैं, annually पूछ सकते हैं, monthly, weekly पूछ सकते हैं. तो you should be focusing on this word called what? Quarterly basis shall be sent to India. On quarterly basis, it shall be sent to the India. Fine? Okay, next point. Can we change the place of books of accounts? I want to change from that office to this office. Yes. Can we change the place of keeping the books of accounts? Answer is yes. Absolutely the answer. There are two things you have to understand here. Either board resolution is required or special resolution is required. Board resolution is required if you are making a change within the same city. Special resolution is required if you are changing the city. Did you get the point? So, what are the resolutions you need? BR or SR. When BR is enough? Within the same. And SR? Beyond the city. Okay? So, right. Change in place of books of accounts. BR. SR within same city, municipal limits, beyond city, SR. लेकिन there is one rule. What is the rule? इन दोनों bracket को close करके लिखना. In such cases, न्यू एड्रेस, न्यू कम्युनिकेशन एड्रेस शैल बी इंटीमेटेड टू होम ROC इन AOC 5 विद इन 7 days ऑफ रेजोल्यूशन. Whatever the resolution you pass doesn't make any difference. Within 7 days, the new address must be updated with whom? ROC. In form number AOC 5. Done? Done, sir? Okay? Now, in such case, new communication address shall be intimated to the ROC in AOC 5 within 7 days of resolution. This is called our first column. Huge. Starting from there. Okay, sir? Then, shall we move to the next part? Now, what is our next part? Next part says that ki books of accounts in electronic form. Nowadays, though, you all know that Information Technology Act 2008 certifies that ki electronic transfers, electronic books, everything is allowed. So, they are saying that if you want to prepare the books of accounts in which form? Electronic form. Then, there are some conditions to be satisfied. Sir, what are those conditions? Condition number one, maintained on Indian cloud server. You are not allowed to maintain it on foreign cloud server. Condition number two, must be accessible only in India. Those books of accounts can or shall must be accessed only in India. You are not allowed to access it outside India. Then third one, must be maintained in its original form. Sir, what do you mean by original form? You are not allowed to alter it. You are not allowed to use any kind of specific and special language for those books of accounts. Schedule 3 ke according, original form mein maintain hone chahiye. It's just that you are not maintaining it manually, you are maintaining it what? Electronically. So in its original form. So teen condition batao mereko. Indian cloud server, accessible in India, in its original form. Branch books maintained at head office. Tell me, I am talking about which kind of branches? Which kind of branches we are talking about here? Dependent one. Branch books which are maintained at head office must be maintained in unaltered form. Matlab, you are not supposed to do any kind of change just because you are a head office. Are you getting the point? Jo branch ne books bheje, wo apne head office mein rakho in an unaltered form. You are not supposed to do any kind of modification or alteration in the branch books. Okay, next point, on-site and off-site backup. Make sure that you are taking the backups on regular intervals. On-site and off-site backup ka matlab kya hua? On-site means what and what do you mean by off-site? Ek backup company mein rakhna hai, ek backup other than company mein rakhna hai. Ghar pe rakho, shop pe rakho, kahin pe rakho. Company mein ek backup और एक बैकअप कहीं और पे. द रीजन इज वेरी सिंपल, क्योंकि सपोज इन केस देयर इज अ शटडाउन और फ्लड्स केम और एनीथिंग मे हैपन, योर टोटल बिजनेस इज शट डाउन, यू विल बी हैविंग अ बैकअप टू रिज्यूम इट अगेन. तो कंपनी वाला बैकअप तो चला जाएगा, तो एटलीस्ट तुम्हारे पास एक अदर बैकअप विल बी देयर. तो टू बैकअप्स, ऑन सेट बैकअप एंड ऑफ सेट बैकअप. एंड फाइव कंडीशंस हो गए ना. कंडीशन नंबर सिक्स, सच बुक्स मस्ट बी कैपेबल ऑफ. ये जो बुक्स हम लोग किसी भी सॉफ्टवेयर में, व्हाटएवर द सॉफ्टवेयर यू आर यूजिंग, must be capable of being displayed, stored, retrieved, and printed. They should be displayable in nature. It should have been capacity of being stored. Unko store karne ki facility honi chahiye software mein. You should have a facility of printing in the software. I want debtors less than 180 days. I should be in a position to get the print. Control P marke. I should get the information. So display honi chahiye. Retrieved honi chahiye. Whatever the information I want, I should be able to retrieve like a manual. I want to see the sales of 2nd December 2019. Can I see that? In a manual? Yes. Same thing should be there in computerized books also. So first point. What is the first point? Displayable, stored, retrieved and printing. Whenever, whatever I want, it should be capable. If you are able to satisfy all these six conditions, you are allowed to meet the books of accounts in which form? Electronic one. Tell me now six conditions. Keywords batao jaldi jaldi. Accessible in India, on Indian cloud server, onset offset backup, original form, branch books in unaltered form, and displayable, retrievable, storable, and printable. Inko kuch bhi karna ho, tum kar sakte ho. And along with that, additional three more things are there. Name of internet service provider or network service provider. Whatever the internet service provider you have and whatever the network service provider you have as a company, its name. IP address of internet service provider or network service provider. Location of internet service provider or network service provider must be filed with whom? ROC. ये तो मैं सब कुछ फाइल करना है किसके साथ आरओसी के साथ देन ओनली यू आर अलाउड टू मेंटेन द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स इन व्हिच फॉर्म इलेक्ट्रॉनिक फॉर्म मैनर ऑफ रिट्रीवल हाँ दैट ऑलरेडी यहाँ पे कवर्ड हो गया ना कैपेबल ऑफ पिंग हाँ यू कैन ऑल्सो से दैट कि यू शुड हैव टू इन्फॉर्म द आरओसी ऑल्सो कि इन विच फॉर्मेट यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स so that whenever they want to retrieve it or want to inspect it, they should be in a position to do it. The manner of retrieval also, you can write one point, manner as a fourth point, manner of retrieval also. To be intimated. Understood? This is what you brings an end to your second column of section number 128, which talks about books of accounts in which form? Electronic form. Done, sir? Second column. Like this. 128 is coming. I hope you understood. Samajh mein? Now, what is the third column? Inspection. Chalo, let's first do inspection. Uske baad karenge preservation. Inspection. Sir, who can inspect, who cannot inspect? Books of accounts, not financial statement. Members are prohibited. Directors are allowed. Reason. First of all, though, you are not aware that members are prohibited. Members can inspect financial statements. They can never inspect what? Books of accounts. Financial statements are always kept open for inspection. Before AGM, during the business hours, they can do the inspection. Books of accounts are never. Sir, members, हमने तो सुना हुआ है सब कुछ कर सकते हैं. Registers देख सकते हो. Register of shareholders, register. They are not books of accounts. They are registers and returns. Registers and returns inspection is your right, but inspection of books of accounts is prohibited to a member. बहुत ही rare case होता है where the member can do, but extremely prohibited. Who can inspect? Books of accounts. My question is reason. Members ko kyun away kar diya from this right? Sir, books of accounts includes day-to-day operations of the entity. They are the responsibility of whom? Management. If we'll allow the shareholders or the members to poke their nose into the day-to-day business, management will be irritated. So if you remember in the company law, we have understood that management and ownership both are separated. from each other. Yeah, the companies ke first chapter mein, in the feature, one of the feature of companies, management and ownership, both are separated from each other. So books of account kis chi responsibility hai? Directors ki hai, management ki hai. So let them inspect it. Financial statements are meant for whom? Members. They have the right to inspect it. ठीक है, तो यहां पे लिखो डायरेक्टर्स अलाउड और सेकेंड पॉइंट के लिखेंगे मेंबर्स नॉट अलाउड. डायरेक्टर्स अलाउड है, मेंबर्स नहीं अलाउड है. ठीक है, कॉस्ट ऑफ इंस्पेक्शन, डू दे चार्ज एनीथिंग? यस, ₹10 ₹50 per inspection. This is for inspection, ₹50. But if you want to take the copies of that, then ₹10 per page for extracts or copies. ₹50 per inspection, ₹10 per page for extracts or copies. हाँ तो सर, यू आर गोइंग टू मेक दम अवेलेबल ना, कुछ तो चार्ज लेंगे ना. फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट कर दिया तो कोई भी मुंह उठा के आ जाएगा. मेरे को आज मैं चलो मैं निकला, मेरा मूड मतलब आई एम फीलिंग बोर्ड, चलो रिलायंस इंडिया के ऑफिस चलते हैं, उनकी बुक्स देख लेते हैं. अगले दिन फिर बोर्ड हूँ, चलो इन्फोसिस चलते हैं. ऐसा करे तो कैसा कॉस्ट? ठीक है, ये कॉस्ट ऑफ इंस्पेक्शन में दीज आर द टू पॉइंट्स यू हैव टू राइट. डन. उसके बाद हु कैन इंस्पेक्ट? डायरेक्टर्स. हु कैन? व्हाट इफ द डायरेक्टर हिमसेल्फ इज कमिंग for inspecting? He can inspect any kind of information in the books of accounts. But if the director himself is not coming, he is sending his legal representative or power of attorney holder or his agent. In that case, such people who are coming on the behalf of whom? Director will not be allowed to have any access over the sensitive or financial information contained in books of accounts. Alone director is coming, it's fine. Uska relative aaya ya एजेंट और लीगल रिप्रेजेंटेटिव या पावर ऑफ अटॉर्नी, दे आर नॉट अलाउड टू हैव अ एक्सेस ओवर द सेंसिटिव इंफॉर्मेशन बिकॉज दैट शुड नॉट बी डिस्क्लोज आउटसाइड. तो यहां पे लिखो इफ डायरेक्टर हिमसेल्फ और हरसेल्फ इज इंस्पेक्टिंग देन एनी एक्सेस एनी इंफॉर्मेशन कैन बी एक्सेस्ड info in books of accounts can be accessed. तो यहां पर लिखना if directors agent और power of attorney holder और legal representative or relative anything then sensitive books of accounts info shall not be allowed to be accessed. Right? Simple. Now your point will come here. What you were saying. Okay, sir, what if the books of accounts are outside India? Ab director inspect kaise karega? मैं इंडिया में हूँ तो आई विल मेक अ रिक्वेस्ट टू द कंपनी कि आई वॉन्ट टू हैव एन इंस्पेक्शन ऑफ योर बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स. देन विद इन 15 डेज ऑफ माई रिक्वेस्ट दोज बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स मस्ट बी प्रोड्यूस इन इंडिया. डोंट मिक्स दिस पॉइंट विद दैट थिंग. क्वार्टरली बेसिस इज देयर ऑब्लिगेशन, दे हैव टू सेंड इट टू इंडियन रजिस्टर्ड ऑफिस. दिस इज स्पेशल रिक्वेस्ट फॉर वॉट? इंस्पेक्शन. तो दिस रिक्वेस्ट मस्ट बी मेट नॉट क्वार्टरली, इट मस्ट बी मेट विद इन 15 डेज ऑफ द रिक्वेस्ट मेड बाय द डायरेक्टर. तो यहाँ पे लिखो इफ books of accounts are outside India, comma, then it shall be produced in India within 15 days of director's request. तो 15 days को underline कर लेना of his request. 15 दिन के अंदर अंदर those books must be presented in India in front of him. And sometimes they may ask you the question, बहुत ही valid question है by the way. I think it is valid. Whether the holding company directors are allowed to access the books of accounts of their subsidiary company. Whether holding company directors are allowed to have an access over the books of accounts of its subsidiary company. Don't you think that subsidiary company is having a separate legal entity? वो तो ownership है ना. ओनरशिप मैनेजमेंट में नहीं आती. हाँ, देर इज अनदर वे ऑल्सो बाई विच समन कैन बिकम योर सब्सिडरी इफ यू कंट्रोल द मोर देन 50% ऑफ कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. तो रिसेंटली दे सेड दैट यस इट इज अलाउड कि होल्डिंग कंपनी डायरेक्टर्स आर अलाउड टू हैव एन एक्सेस ओवर द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स ऑफ सब्सिडरी कंपनी बट नॉट ऑल विल बी अलाउड. बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स ऑफ द होल्डिंग कंपनी विल अपॉइंट वन ऑथराइज डायरेक्टर unanimously of holding company. That director may go to subsidiary company to have an inspection over the books of accounts of subsidiary company. Did you get the point? Just mu utha ke sare director nahi pahunch jana. Ek director ko appoint kiya jayega. Who will appoint? Unanimously the board of directors of the holding company will appoint one director and that director will go to the subsidiary company and shall have an access over what? Books of accounts. Okay? Write this point. In case of subsidiary books, comma, the holding company director authorized by board can access or inspect books of accounts of subsidiary. Very important point. ये क्या होता है कि ये these are the small small points which are hidden in the provisions of section number 128. Once you will read the bare act ना, which I'll make you write on ना, I'll make you read that. You will understand that these points are not given anywhere. Even though given, very corner में in somewhere else you have to locate these points, you know, sometimes. And this brings an end to our one topic only in this column called what? Inspection. What is our another topic? P नहीं नहीं अभी तो inspection खत्म हुआ. Preservation कौन करेगा? Preservation. No, right. Preservation बहुत सिंपल सा वे है टू अंडरस्टैंड इट. इसे तीन पार्ट्स में डिवाइड करो. सिंपल इफ यू हैव अ टाइम प्लेस बिलो. कंपनी इन एग्जिस्टेंस एग्जिस्टेंस फॉर 8 और लेस इयर्स इन एग्जिस्टेंस फॉर मोर देन 8 इयर्स any inspection inquiry investigation is going on. III stands for inspection inquiry investigation is going on. ठीक है. तो company is in existence for 8 or less years, in existence for more than 8 years, any inspection inquiry or that thing, what do we call it as, this thing is going on. Inspection is going on. ठीक है. Now in such case all years, in such case at least 8 accounting years, previous accounting years, current के तो you are preparing ना, तो 8 accounting years should be kept in your office and till the time such I is getting concluded. First write it, then I'll tell you the meaning. जब तक इंस्पेक्शन इंक्वायरी इन्वेस्टिगेशन खत्म नहीं हो जाती टिल दैट टाइम यू हैव टू प्रिजर्व दिस बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स इफ इट इज गोइंग ऑन सर 10 इयर्स आर ओवर यू टू टोल्ड 8 इयर्स 10 इयर्स यू हैव टू मेंटेन 11 12 30 40 50 इयर्स इफ आई इज गोइंग ऑन एंड इफ कंपनी इज इन एग्जिस्टेंस फॉर लेस देन 8 इयर्स तो ऑल द इयर्स क्योंकि मिनिमम रिक्वायरमेंट इज मिनिमम 8 इयर्स तो मोर देन 8 इयर्स में करंट इज देयर एंड द प्रीवियस लास्ट 8 years. Did you get the point? This is what the provision relating to what? Preservation of books of accounts. So let us proceed with the last thing. Who are the key responsible persons in the particular thing called section number 1? Ye kiski responsibility hai books of accounts? Tell me, books of accounts is the primary responsibility of whom? I know management. Management mein bhi toh bahut sare hote na. Management hai, TCWG hai. Now, it is a prime responsibility to write key responsible persons for the compliance of 128. Who are the key responsible persons? MD, CFO, not CEO. MD, CFO, and third, whole time director of finance department. Not any other whole time director of finance department. These are the three key members who are going to be responsibly held for section number 128. Managing director, CFO or whole time director, or if none of above is present in the organization, all directors. तो पहले KMP को हम लोग target कर रहे हैं, KMP के नीचे आके directors को target कर रहे हैं. तुम simple सी बात है sir, preparation तो board of directors ने कर दी. कंप्लायंसेस को चेक करना बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स की बात नहीं है. वो कौन रिस्पॉन्स, अगर कुछ हुआ गलत 128 में तो सीधा जाके सीएफओ का कॉलर पकड़ेंगे, एमडी का पकड़ेंगे, होल टाइम डायरेक्टर ऑफ फाइनेंस डिपार्टमेंट का पकड़ेंगे. तुम्हें पैसे किस बात के मिल रहे? सीएफओ का मतलब क्या है? व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ सीएफओ? तो फाइनेंशियल ऑफिसर मतलब ये फाइनेंशियल इंफॉर्मेशन तुम्हारी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है ना. होल टाइम डायरेक्टर ऑफ विच डिपार्टमेंट? और मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर की डेफिनेशन क्या होता है? हु इज हैविंग द सब्सटेंशियल पावर्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट, जिसके पास सब्सटेंशियल पावर्स है. तुम तीनों के पास पावर थी, स्टिल 128 हैज बीन वायलेटेड, देन यू विल बी हेल्ड रिस्पॉन्सिबल. बट सम कंपनीज आर अनेबल टू अफोर्ड दिस पीपल, देन इन द सच केस व्हाट विल हैपन? ऑल डायरेक्टर्स. और इनका पेनल्टी क्या है ऑन नॉन कंप्लायंस? बहुत सिंपल पेनल्टी है, मिनिमम 50K है, मैक्सिमम 5 लाख है. तो मिनिमम 50,000 है, मैक्सिमम 5 लाख है, और they will be imprisoned up to 1 year, or मतलब they can go away with the fine, imprisonment up to 1 year or both. And the good thing is section 129 and 128 की penalty same है, और ये point ही same है पूरा. मतलब 129 में I am not going to cover it, already covered. 128 के भी key responsible persons are same, and 128 की penalty on violation is also same. So what is the penalty? Minimum 50,000, maximum 5 lakhs, or imprisonment up to 1 year, or both. Same penalty will change in 134. Imprisonment ho jayegi 3 years. 134 kya hai? Dekho list mein, board report mein. Ye connected sections hai. Toh penalty is also like normal. Theek hai, books of accounts nahi bane toh chota mota penalty dalo. 5 lakh ka, 1 saal ki imprisonment dalo, or both. Toh or hai, toh it is compoundable offense. मतलब यू कैन गेट अवे बाय पेइंग फाइन ऑल्सो. बट हु आर द की केआरपीस? मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर, सीएफओ एंड होल टाइम डायरेक्टर ऑफ विच डिपार्टमेंट? फाइनेंस. एल्स ऑल डायरेक्टर. दैट ब्रिंग्स एन एंड टू द सेक्शन नंबर